Big play for Stanford off the season.
They mark it at the 14-yard line. The Cardinal in business here. That's exactly what Ty Willingham was talking to us about yesterday, making some noise early in the game. Single setback this time for the Cardinal, two tight ends. Straight back for Sonny, three-step drop, throws underneath, and it's caught. Looked like it might have been dropped. Brent Pierce with the reception at about the 8-yard line. It'll be a gain of 6.
Well, I like they're going to a little bit more higher percentage pass for Fasani. Get him involved in the ball game. He went deep the first few times in the first series, and that's not what you want your quarterback to do to start off the season. You want to go with the higher percentage passes, especially down here in the plus territory.
And as I said, originally, Pierce did not make that catch. He dropped the ball. Incomplete pass, second down. Out of the I formation. Late blitz comes. Fasani lobs for the end zone. Powell can't hang on. Nice defensive play that time by Lenny Walls. And Walls at 6'4", playing against the 5'8 Powell, and it paid off there.
There's no question Lenny Walls has a height advantage there, and that ball kind of hung up in the air a little bit. Here you can see that Powell's running a little fade route, and Lenny Walls does a great job of finding the ball in the air, and you see that height advantage he has, but he's able to get back and tip the ball away just at the last second.
Lenny Walls, a Bay Area product, born and raised, went to school in San Francisco at Galileo High School. Transferred to Boston College from St. Mary's because his brother was a basketball player at BC. Fasani straight back, fumbles the football, BC has it. Scott Bradley with the big push, gets the sack. Antonio Garay with the recovery, and just like that, the Eagles make a big play. So a rough start for Randy Fasani out of the box. Boston College will have it at their own 32-yard line when we come back. Well, we've had two big plays in 16 seconds, a block punt and a fumble.
Not a good start for Mr. Fasani. He's already 0-for-4, and with a fumble, that's not the way you want to start your season off. Here you can see Scott Bradley and Doug Bissett come off that right side. And Bradley just puts his helmet right on the quarterback and strips the ball at the same time. Great play for Boston College to get out of bad field position.
Wow, that was a big time play. St. Pierre this time rolls out, flag down. St. Pierre rolling to his right, now he throws, and it's incomplete. Intended for Dedrick DeWalt. We'll see about the flag.
Intended for number 11, Dedrick DeWalt. Incomplete, covered by Root.
So we await the flag.
Offsides, defense, got at least 5 yards from the previous spot. Repeat first down.
Well, Stanford, of course, is not prone to making a lot of penalties. They have been the least penalized team in the Pac-10 Conference the last few years.
That's something Ty Willingham preaches all the time. You got to play mistake-free football. He's always been that way, even when he coached with me at Minnesota.
And his team, of course, has not done that so far. It's uncharacteristic. Here's a pitch back to St. Pierre. Going for the ball. He's got DeWalt out there and he overthrew it. That was going to be 6.
He had DeWalt wide open down there, but he was rushed a little bit on that play and had to let go of it before he wanted to. Put it out there far enough, but just a little bit too far for DeWalt.
It was the old flea flicker. He ran out a few times, didn't he?
Oh, yeah. Everybody comes up there on green. He pitches it back. Good pitch. But number 92, Marcus Hoover, really put some pressure on him, made him throw the football before he wanted to.
So it'll be 2nd and 5. Good time for that play, though, coming off the offside penalty against Stanford. St. Pierre this time gives to Green. Green gets to the corner, and that is run out of bounds nicely by Matt Friedrichs and Simba Hodari. So now it'll be 3rd and 4. They bring Ryan Reed to the near side. 3 wide receivers. Keith Hennings now makes it a trips right set. Green the long setback. Stanford comes with a blitz. St. Pierre throws underneath. It is caught by Hennings, but I don't know. Maybe he might have enough. It'll be very close to a first down. I believe he's got it.
It looks close from here. Great effort by Hennings to try and get the first down.
This time Reed splits to the far side and they slide Hennings inside of him. Ball at the 37-yard line. Here's a pitch to Green on the option. Green turns the corner, gets it upfield for about five. Coy Wire runs him down. That play was very successful last week against West Virginia.
It really was, and you can tell when coaches see success, they're going to come back with it the next week. Even though BC isn't an option football team, because of the success they had last week, they're going to use it again this week to see if Stanford is prepared for it and how they're going to stop it.
Yeah, that's what Tom O'Brien told us yesterday. He said, we really didn't intend to run the option all that much. But he said, they never adjusted to it. We just kept running. Second and five, long five at that. There's the option the other way. And Sampier cuts it up, and Coy Wire meets it. Well, Wire, very active, isn't he?
Very active football player, always around the football. And this is something you don't want to do with your quarterback too much, is keep turning him up inside, running the football, especially when he's not used to that. This, he isn't an option quarterback. He's a passing quarterback that has the ability to run.
In fact, he told us yesterday, he said, I came to Boston College because they run a pro-style offense. Now what's happening?
Exactly. He's running the option two games in a row here, but he also said he's willing to do whatever it takes to help his team win, which is a great attitude.
Good play here for both teams. Third down and three, slot left. And here's a run back pitch. And this is DeWalt with all kinds of room. Midfield with a 40. It's a foot race. And out of bounds at the 27-yard line. Huge play. Dedrick DeWalt, who's their big play guy, and a late flag comes in. And that may cost Stanford some more.
Well, this play was set up by the option. They run the option two plays prior to that. They show you option coming. They show you option coming to the left side, but then they bring DeWalt back around on the reverse, and there's nobody on that right side. Number 78,
personal
can't.
Defense.
And it was a late hit by Reuben Carter.
Augie Hoffman had a hard time trying to keep up with Mr. DeWalt as he pulled around that right side, but there was no one over there.
So that'll give BC the ball at the 14-yard line. This is exactly the start that Tom O'Brien wanted. Defense makes a big play, and the offense moves the football.
Well, they've turned that field position around, and they've gotten the ball, and now they made the big play to get themselves in the scoring position. Exactly what you want is to start off a game, especially on the road.
First down at the 14-yard line. This is Green. Green is stopped before he got to the line of scrimmage by Matt Friedrichs. Slipped a little bit as he got to the line.
Boston College showing a lot of different formation looks this week. They were pretty basic last week, but they've really come out and shown a lot of different formations, trips to one side. They've shown three receivers. They've shown the I formation. A lot of different looks they're showing the Stanford Cardinal early in the ballgame.
You know, and I think that that all plays very well for them because they beat West Virginia without having to show
too much. Exactly.
Slot left on second and 10. Play fake, Sampier to throw, throws to the end zone, and overthrows his intended receiver, Ryan Reed, who cut his pattern off.
He had Ryan Reed open on the post pattern, there's no question about it, but the ball just kind of sailed on him. He'd love to have that one back, I'm sure.
So it'll be third down and 10 now, the ball sitting just short of the 15-yard line. Both defenses stepping up when they need to. Amon Gordon is in the Stanford lineup defensively now, and we'll talk a little bit more about him, but Barry gives you some size. This is a dime package for Stanford, six defensive backs. Sampier straight back to pass, and they hit him as he throws, and it's caught by Reed for a touchdown. What a play by Sampier. Austin Lee was right in his grip.
What a great job by Pierre of standing in there, knowing he's going to take one under the chops, and delivers a perfectly thrown ball for the touchdown.
Watch Austin Lee come.
Just a five-step drop, sits in the pocket. Austin Lee lays that helmet right in his sternum, but he delivers a nice, crisp pass for the touchdown. Great play by this young quarterback and a great confidence builder.
One of those touchdown passes the quarterback never sees. I trust you had a few of those.
He just listens for the crowd. Either it's a ooh or an ah.
He got an ah that time. Great play. Sampier over the middle. Reed with the great catch. 7-0 with the conversion. Boston College over Stanford. And there you have both halves of that touchdown pass. Brian Sampier, the quarterback. Ryan Reed, the transfer from Navy, with his second career touchdown reception.
Reed just comes down the field and runs a little seam route, gives a little move to the corner and comes up the seam and beats Jason Taylor and also beats the safety man coming over, who was Jason White on the plate. Excellently delivered pass by Brian St. Pierre. Touchdown, big play for Boston College, no question about it.
And what really has shown itself so far is Boston College has played a game, won a game. They're clicking on all cylinders. Stanford's really stutter-stepping here.
They really are trying to find themselves, and right here they've got to get something going offensively.
Here's Wells on the return, bounces off a man and actually lost a little yardage. And Stanford's going to have to start way in its own territory. Kazani, as you mentioned earlier, 0-for-4.
Eagle,
including a fumble.
Eagle.
So he's not getting it done so far. Nine plays, 74 yards, used 3 minutes and 38 seconds of the clock. The big play, that 28-yard pitch back to DeWalt on a third down play. And Stanford added to its own troubles with a 15-yard penalty. So now Fizzani will try to get the Stanford offensive gear. This is Wells. And Moore, rather, Casey Moore, with a gain of about 8. Give Moore 9 yards on that carry. Second and short. Fizzani rolling to his left. Throws wide open was the tight end, Pearson. Fizzani had a throw across his body. It's a tough throw to make, isn't it?
It really is a tough throw, especially for a right-hander going to his left, trying to get those shoulders turned, especially when you have a big defensive lineman barreling down on you. He couldn't quite get what he wanted on that football because he couldn't get those shoulders turned to the line of scrimmage.
So it'll be third down and short. And then Powell to the near side, slot Wells inside of it. Kazani this time gives to Allen. Allen will have the first down across the 30 to the 31. Stanford will use a two running back system. Brian Allen and Kerry Carter both will get about equal time. Tom Martin made the stop, but a first down for the Carter.
Well, this will help Randy get into the flow of the ball game by getting his running game going, trying to develop a rhythm with the offense.
Gary Camarillo in the ball game for the first time. They give to Carter, and he has stopped right now. Blowing in that time was Douglas Goodwin. Right now, let's go to our College Football Saturday studio for a game break with Kevin Frazier. Kev? Well, Oregon making it two in a row. Neither one was particularly easy. Second down and 12 for the Cardinals. Play fake, Fizzani to throw, in trouble, steps up, and he goes down hard at about the 27-yard line. Fizzani not having any time. BC putting a pretty good push on him.
They really are. They're coming with pressure from both sides. He tried to step up on that one, but Sean Guthrie came from the backside and made the play. Fizzani's under all kind of pressure right now. They've got to get that running game going so they can keep this team off balance a little bit so they can't fire all these people at him.
So third down and 13. Nickel defense, third and 14, actually. Nickel defense for Boston College. They've been Bowman in motion. Fizzani straight back again. Little jailbreak screen that doesn't go anywhere. Won the jailbreak. Luke Powell made the catch, and Tom Martin wrapped him up right now, and Stanford will give it up again.
Nothing working for the Stanford Cardinal right now. They tried to go with this little slip screen to the wide receiver, but they're all over it. Lenny Walls was playing very well, right on top of it.
So Johnson will come on to punt for the second time. Dedrick DeWalt will be the deep man, standing at the 31-yard line. They come after this one. Johnson a little bit slow also. Short kick. DeWalt will let it bounce. It takes a Stanford bounce and will get inside the 30-yard line to about the 25. Seemed a little bit slow, though, to get that ball off.
Really did. And you got to do a better job of getting that ball off, especially under pressure.
7-0 Eagles. They'll have the ball when we come back. Eagles lead it by 7, and so far they've been absolutely dominant, Warren.
No question about it. BC is dominating the total offense. Is 61 to minus 1 yard for the Stanford Cardinal. They've got to be over on that sideline trying to figure out what the heck's going on and what are we going to do to turn this thing around.
Well, they've got it at the 25-yard line. They drove 78 yards last time they had. St-Pierre going to put it up on first down. Throws for Reed, and he can't hang on. He's wide open. St-Pierre put it right on his hands. Let's go to the sidelines right now. And Jimmy Watson. Jimmy, what's up?
Barry, already you've mentioned Antonio Gray a number of times tonight. Recovered that fumble. It's a great story. Last year, he blew out his ACL in the very first defensive series of the year. He had the surgery and came back the next season. Not the next football season, but the next wrestling season. He's a heavyweight for BC and a pretty good one. He went to the quarterfinals of the NCAAs. This week, Sports Illustrated featured him in an article. I asked him about it before the game. He said, "What article?" A lot of athletes talk about not reading their own press clippings. This is a guy who really lives it.
Thanks a lot, Jimmy. So there'll be no Sports Illustrated jinx for him. St-Pierre throws wide open underneath DeWalt. First down at the 39-yard line. I mean, wide open.
Really wide open. Really impressed with Brian St-Pierre early in this ball game, as opposed to last week when he got off to a very slow start. Seems to really be in a rhythm. Good job in the pocket. Gets good balance under his feet and delivers the ball right on the chest where you want the football. First down, Boston College.
Did a great job. He had a sore arm last week, a muscle sort of underneath his arm. And it bothered him, he said, on his follow through. But tonight, obviously not bothering him at all. Give it to Green. Green at the right side is hit almost immediately. Gets about 2. Ryan Fernandez, first man to him with help from Matt Friedrichs.
Really like how Boston College is mixing up their play calling, mixing up the formations, throwing the ball on first down. They give you a little bit of green on second down. This really keeps the defense off balance and kind of lets you as an offense dictate what you're going to do offensively.
Give Green a couple and it'll be 2nd and 8. Stanford obviously concentrating on stopping Reed Green. St-Pierre has been hurting him with his passing. This is Green again, and a little confusion in the backfield. Green was going to one side. St-Pierre thought he was going to the other side.
It looked like there was a little confusion on this handoff. St-Pierre reversed out from the center, and it looked like Green was expecting him to come straight out from under the center, and there was a little miscommunication there, and you can see Mr. Green just tried to get whatever he could out of this play, but it was a loss.
Makes it 3rd down and 12. Green so far, 6 carries for minus 3. Out of the shotgun. St-Pierre straight back. Blitz comes. St-Pierre throws, caught by DeWalt. It'll be short of the first down, but again, St-Pierre just hanging in there in the face of a blitz.
Really is standing in there great. Delivered that ball right on the money, and this time they make the catch where earlier in the drive the ball was dropped.
St-Pierre was telling us yesterday that he and Dedrick DeWalt worked together all summer long. They feel a great cohesion with one another. There's the punt, a line drive kick. Powell might have a chance here at the 10-yard line. Starts right back up the middle, gets the 15, gets the 20, breaks it outside, got the kick to the beat. And lost his footing for a moment, bounces outside again. He's in midfield, he's the 45. And down at the 42, what a run by Luke Powell.
What an exciting run by Luke Powell. Wow, if he doesn't stumble, he goes the distance, Barry.
And the snapper, Francois Brochu, makes the stop, a 49-yard return. Look at this.
Great job by Powell of setting up his blocks, and he just hits that seam. Nice little move here on the punter, and here he just stumbles a little bit. Otherwise, he was going to the house, but he still is able to regain his balance, get back on his feet, and make some more yards after the stumble, and just a great play for Stanford. Stanford, hopefully this will get them on the right track offensively.
They start at the 42-yard line of Boston College. Jared Newberry in at fullback for the first time tonight. And they give to Kerry Carter, and Carter tries to step outside and does at the 40, 35, 30, and out of bounds. Right at about the 30-yard line. Now, Kerry Carter is a bigger back than Brian Allen. The two of them really give you a different kind of look.
They really do. Brian Allen is more of a scat back. He's going to get up in there and make things happen, but Kerry Carter is a big, strong tailback who can break tackles like he shows right here. Puts that shoulder down, gives him nothing but shoulders and knees to hit, and look at him, this big strong guy that hard to bring down and makes a first down.
Three wideouts for Stanford now on first down. Pisani to throw again. He's flushed out of the pocket. Now he can run 30, 25. Got a nice block that time from Kerry Carter that gave him about four more yards.
And this is what they like about Randy Pisani. He can not only throw the football, but he runs the football very well. He wasn't healthy all the time last year, but this year, since he's healthy, he had a knee problem, had a little toe problem, but because he's healthy now, they really feel like he can make these kind of plays out of the pocket.
So Stanford back-to-back first downs. They have it inside the 20 at the 19-yard line. Single setback, three wideouts for Stanford now. Pisani might be checking off here. Pisani, straight back, short drop. Now he rolls out. And now he's in big trouble. Gets away from it. Straightens up and throws. The ball is caught this time for a touchdown by Nick Sebas. A broken play. Give all the credit on that one to Pisani.
You've got to give the credit to Pisani on this one. This was all individual effort. Couldn't find his first man, scrambles around and makes a big play, and this is what Stanford needed to get that monkey off their back. Here he rolls out to the left, and that's a hard throw to make to your left, but he delivers it right on the numbers to Sebas, and Sebas takes it in for the touchdown. Stanford's on the board finally, Barry.
Well, it might not have been the way they drew it up.
It definitely wasn't the way they drew it up.
He's going to take it. Pacelli to try the point to make this a 7-7 game. Up and through, and this game is tied at 7. So with 2:04 remaining in the first quarter, we'll look at the scoreboard. Shows the Cardinals 7, the Eagles 7. We'll be back. Well, once again, Warren, I feel like I'm being a bit redundant, but Ty Willingham told us they had to make big plays. They got a couple of them here, and it started with Luke Powell.
It really did. It started with the punt return, and Luke Powell got everything going by just having a tremendous return. And it shows what a big play like that can do for your football team.
Pacelli kicks it off, a short kick. And this one is going to be returned by Burke. And Burke gets it up to about the 34-yard line. It looked like he was about to break. Let's take a look at that punt return of Luke Powell's. And it was a thing of beauty.
It really was. Again, he sets up his blocks very well. He hits the seam right here and then accelerates. Now he comes up to the punter, McMiler, and makes a great move on him, but stumbles a little bit. And then he's able to regain his footing, make a couple of spin moves, and still create yardage down the field. Just an excellent punt return by Luke Powell.
49 yards, and then the touchdown pass.
Watch the strength by Pisani. He really has great upper body strength. Turns, throws that ball with nice composure right on the numbers. DeSebus takes it in for the touchdown. Stanford needed this type of play to get back in this ball game.
Derek Knight is now the tailback. St. Pierre going to put it up on first down, looking for it all. Looking for DeWalt, and Fernando's a nice defensive job to knock it down. That was well defended by the Stanford Cardinal.
It really was. St. Pierre showed option, came down the line, and then dropped back, trying to get those defensive backs to suck up, and they didn't suck up. Brian Fernandez stayed back there on his man. Great coverage on the play, and that ball really hung up in the air. He's fortunate that play wasn't intercepted.
I think Fernandez might have been thinking, if I go for this and miss it, it's a touchdown.
Exactly. He's got to play the man and the ball at the same time instead of playing the ball and the man.
So it'll be second down and 10. Play fake again. Blitz comes again. Saint-Pierre hit as he throws. Reed makes the catch. That's going to be a first down just short of midfield. And again, Saint-Pierre took a shot from Gary Cobb, who was coming off the corner.
But again, he delivers it right on the money, and that out route has been there all day. He's completed his last two, and he had one dropped earlier before that. Here's a little play action fake. Delivers the ball just as he's getting hit from the backside by the backside corner. Another nicely thrown football by Brian Saint-Pierre.
So first down Eagles at the 49 as they come right back. Slot left with Hennings in the slot. Here's the option again. Saint-Pierre keeps it, turns it up, gets across midfield to the 48-yard line.
I know you really like them, and Bruins had a big win today, too, also against Kansas.
Straight back Saint-Pierre on second down. Throws for DeWalt, overthrows it.
Again, he had that out route. He just got the ball out in front of him a little bit too much there, but that out route is there. Fernandez has given a little bit too much ground out there. He must really be respecting Dedrick DeWalt's speed.
He's got good speed. What did they say? 4.46, I think.
4.46, 10.400 meters. That's flying.
And what they said, though, is he's not a track guy playing football. He's a football guy running track.
Exactly. Went out for track just so he could improve his speed. And that's what you want your guys to do in the offseason. Try and do things to improve their game.
Three wideouts for Boston College. Nickel defense for Stanford. St. Pierre this time is wrapped up and dropped by Matt Renner.
And this is the first time all day that he's had some pressure, and finally they got to him. This is what this defensive front is going to have to do. Get some pressure on St. Pierre so he can't sit back there and just be relaxed and throw the football.
So a good defensive set for the Stanford Cardinal following the touchdown. And Luke Powell now may have another chance. Punting game has not been good for BC. They had one blocked and had a 49-yard return. Short twisting kick, fair catch called by Powell, and he makes it at the 24-yard line. And with that, we come to the end of the first quarter with a look at the scoreboard. Going to Stanford Cardinals 7, the Boston College Eagles 7. We'll come back. Second quarter action coming up from Stanford Stadium right after this.
Doing good. Doing good. Oh, Warren, I thought pretty interesting first quarter, actually. A lot of ebb and flow here.
Exactly. You had turnovers, you had big plays, everything that you wanted in a football game all happened in the first quarter. So if that's any indication, boy, these next three quarters are going to be pretty exciting.
Interesting. Now, Boston College going with a second line defensive line. Derek Rossi, Keith Levitt, Tim Bullman, and Philip Metling. He's trying to get some experience here. A show blitz. Stanford left a little early. Greg Schindler is an experienced lineman. In fact, Stanford's entire offensive line is experienced.
It looked like Randy was trying to go on a longer count there and maybe try and jump them offsides. And he got his own man, Schindler, who's a senior and shouldn't make those mistakes.
It's three penalties for the Stanford Cardinal, which is very much out of character, but also indicative of a first game. Slot right. Evan Carter in motion. Kazani rolls, throws behind Caleb Bowman.
I know Randy wishes he could get that pass back because he had Caleb open in the flat. Ball just got a little bit behind him. And Caleb wasn't able to twist his body and make a great catch for him, but Randy will complete that pass 9 times out of 10.
Well, you know, I imagine it's like a fighter. You know, you got to get out there and take that first shot before you really feel comfortable.
And that's why they're giving him these high percentage passes to get him into a rhythm.
Second down and 15. Long count by Pizzani. Pitch to Carter. Carter cuts back. Hurdles in hand. Gets up to the 30-yard line. What a nice run. Let's go somewhere in the maddening crowd to Jimmy Watson. Jimmy, what's up?
You know, Barry, when Randy Pizzani just threw that last touchdown, of course, everybody here at Stanford Stadium went crazy. Nobody cheered louder than this young lady right here. Her name is Monica, and it used to be Monica Starr, but now it's Pizzani. You guys got married just a couple weeks ago.
Yes, August 4th.
What was that like? Must be very exciting for you.
It was so exciting. It was the best time of our lives.
This is a guy you've known for a long time. Talk about when you guys met.
Actually, we met back in high school from our church group 6 years ago, so we've known each other for a long time.
What is Randy like during game week? Does he get a little quiet and hold himself?
No, this week he was just so excited. He was ready to get going, just excited for football season.
This whole stadium goes crazy. The people here, no, they not only make noise, but they look a little different too. Everybody here wears lime green. What is this about? This is the Pizzani cheering section?
The Pizzani fan club, yes.
Over 50 people, and they come to every game, and they cheer Randy Pizzani. Monica, congratulations.
Thank you.
Send it back up to Barry.
All I can tell is looking at that fan club, they must have had a heck of a wedding.
They're probably still partying from the wedding.
Well, Randy Pizzani almost threw a pick while Monica was talking with us, but unable to hold on was Wells, and so Stanford will punt it away. Bounce and Moore will down it at about the 37-yard line. So the Eagles will have it as the Pizzani fan club and its cheerleader on the right there root on their guy. We're coming back. Just about a minute into the second quarter, it's a 7-7 ball game. Barry Tompkins, Warren Moon, Jim Watson here at Stanford Stadium on a beautiful night, telling you about it. been an entertaining football game so far. Maybe not one you would want to put into a time capsule if you were a coach. Quinton Porter now, the freshman, first-year freshman out of Portland, Maine, will get a series at quarterback. This is something that Tom O'Brien does. He did it last year with St. Pierre. I'll tell you about his reasoning. Porter throws, and the ball is caught.
Nicely delivered ball by the freshman. He drops back, three-step drop, a little play-action fake, and puts the ball on a hitch route to the wideout on the outside, number 14, Ryan Reed.
Reed's been quite a receiver so far tonight.
He really has. He's made some big plays for a guy that's not a starter.
Yeah, the thinking on the part of Tom O'Brien is that if a guy has to come into a ball game late in the game in a pressure situation, I want him to know what it's like to be on a field in the heat of a battle. A little confusion in the Stanford secondary. They got a guy on cover. And again, to Green. Green has stopped for a loss.